Hello students, what is going on? Myself Abdullah Momin, and in this video we are going to see the numericals of chapter number 5, oscillation, that is from class 12th standard physics, Maharashtra State Board. So the very first numerical which is given in your textbook is a body of mass 2 kg performs linear SHM. It experiences a restoring force of 0.2 Newton. So this is the mass of the body, which is 0.2 kg, and the restoring force F is 0.2 Newton. When its displacement from the mean position is 4 cm. So displacement of the body is given, that is 4 cm, and when you will convert it into meter, we will multiply it with 10^-2. So we are supposed to find out force constant, that is K, period of SHM, and acceleration of the body when its displacement from the mean position is 1 cm. So the formula of force constant, or we know that if a body is performing SHM, so these are the given quantities, and we are supposed to find out number one, force constant, which is K, number two, time period, that is T, and number three, acceleration of a body at a displacement 1 cm. So the formula, we know that the formula of force constant or restoring force is kx. So from this equation we can write K is equal to F by x. So the restoring force is 0.2 and the displacement is 0.04. This displacement can be written as 0.04 meter. So K can be written as 0.2 upon 0.04, and when you will solve it, you will get 5 newton per meter. So the force constant is 5 newton per meter, and we know that the formula of omega is equal to 2 pi by capital T. So we will write T is equal to 2 pi by omega. So we know that the formula of omega is root K by M. So when you will put this formula into this equation, we will get T is equal to 2 pi divided by root K by M. So we will write 2 pi into root M by K. So we will get this formula, 2 pi root M by K. M is mass of the body, K is force constant. So we have the value of force constant. So when you will put this value, you will get 0.4 pi. And if it is time period, we will write second. Now we are supposed to calculate the acceleration at a displacement of 1 cm from the mean position. So instead of 0.04, we will put 0.01. This is wrong. So when you will solve this, you will get 50 by 2, which can be written as 25. So we will get 25 meter per second square. The next numerical is a particle performs linear SHM of time period or period T 4 second and amplitude 4 centimeter, find the time taken by it to travel a distance of 1 centimeter from the positive extreme position. So we have the equation of displacement of a particle. Since the particle performs SHM from the positive extreme position, so its phase can be written as pi by 2. And its amplitude is 4 centimeter. So now the particle is at a distance 1 centimeter. This distance is 1 centimeter. This distance is 4 centimeter. So we can write this distance as 3 centimeter. So now the particle is at a position 3 centimeter from the mean position. So this is 3, amplitude is 4, sine omega, omega is can be written as 2 pi by t into t plus pi by 2. So this 4 goes to another side, it can become 3, and sine theta plus 90. Sine theta plus 90 means sine theta plus pi by 2 is equal to cos theta. So this is theta, this is sine theta plus 90 means cos theta. So 2 pi by t, that is the value of capital T. When you will solve it, you will get this value, and cos theta is 3 pi by 4, that means cos goes to another side and it can be write pi by 2 into t cos inverse of 3 by 4. 3 by 4 can be written as 0.75. so when you will see the cos of from the logbook, you will get 41.4 degree. You will convert it into radian, so we will multiply it by pi by 180. So when you will cancel this 2 pi, these two ones are 290. 41 upon 90, that is 0.4 second. So t is 0.4 second. This is the time taken by the particle to reach from extreme position to 1 centimeter distance. Next numerical is a particle performing linear SHM with period 6 second is at positive extreme position at initial time t0. Now the particle is found to be at a distance from this position at time t7 before reaching the mean position. Find the amplitude. Now what this numerical is saying, a particle performing linear SHM and the time period is, means capital T is 6 second and is at extreme position. Suppose the particle is at extreme position. The particle is found to be at a distance from this position. Extreme position se wo kitne distance pe mil raha hai from this position. Matlab, this distance is your 3 centimeter distance at time, aur yahan tak pahunchne usko laga time 7 second before reaching the mean position pe pahunchne se pehle find the amplitude calculate karna. Since particle starts t is equal to 0 from positive extreme position. So we will write phi is pi by 2 and the distance is, the total distance is a and it is at 3 centimeter, means this position is a minus x, means a minus 3. So x is equal to a sine omega t plus pi by 2. So instead of x we will write a minus 3. This a goes to another side, a minus 3 by a sine 2 pi by t. The value of t is, and the time instant is 7. So we can write 2 1s are 2, 2 3s are 6. So 7 pi by 3 plus pi by a. And this equation can be rewritten as sine pi by 3 plus pi by 2. That sine pi by 3 plus 90 is cos theta. And cos pi by 3 means 1 by 2. So after solving this, we will get the amplitude as 6 centimeter. Next numerical, that is the speed of a particle performing linear SHM are 8 cm and 6 cm at a respective displacement of 6 cm and 8 cm. So when the speed v1 is 8 cm per second, the displacement is 6 cm. And when the speed is 6 cm per second, the displacement is 8 cm. Find its period and amplitude. So we have the equation, speed is equal to omega a square minus x square. So we can write v1 is equal to omega a square minus x1 square divided by v2 square is equal to omega a square minus x2 square. So v1 is 8, v2 is 6, omega omega get cancelled, root a square minus x1 square divided by root a square minus x2 square. So this 4 become 4 by 3. So after solving this equation, squaring on both sides, so we will get 16 by 9 a square minus x1 square upon a square minus x2 square. After cross multiplying it, 16 a square minus x2 square is equal to 9 a square minus x1 square. So 16a square minus 16x2 square is equal to 9a square minus, this is your x1, this is your x2. So we are going to put the value of x1 and x2, and when you will solve it, you will get a is equal to 10 centimeter. Now we will put a is equal to 10 centimeter in v1 equation, and when we will solve that, we will get time period as 6.28 second. Next numerical, that is fifth one, the maximum velocity of a particle performing SHM is 6.28. Maximum velocity means V max is given, that is 6.28 centimeter per second. If the length of its path is 8 centimeter, that is the total path length. If the total length is 8 centimeter, then we will say that the amplitude is 4 centimeter. Calculate its time period. We are supposed to calculate the time period. So we will write V max is equal to 6.28 सेंटीमीटर पर सेकंड एंड 6.28 इज द वैल्यू ऑफ 2 पाई. A is 4 centimeter, so we know that V max is equal to A omega. So instead of omega, we will write 2 pi by T. So T can be written as A into 2 pi upon V max. So T can be written as A, that is 4, 2 pi, V max means 2 pi. 2 pi, 2 pi get cancelled, we will get 4 second. So thank you student, thank you very much. I will catch you next time. Hello students, what is going on? My name is Abdullah Momin from KMES English Medium High School and Junior College. And in this video, we are going to see the numerical part of the chapter oscillation. So in previous part, we have seen that till example 5.5. So this is your example 5.6 from the solved section of the textbook. And the question is, the maximum speed of a particle performing linear SHM is 0.08 meter per second if its maximum acceleration is 0.32 meter per second square. Calculate its period and amplitude. So if the velocity is maximum, we have the formula for maximum velocity, that is A omega, and we have the formula for maximum acceleration, that is A omega square. So while dividing these two equations, A and A get cancelled, omega and omega get cancelled. So we can write A max upon V max is equal to omega, and omega is nothing but 2 pi by capital T. So when T goes to another side, so we can get V max upon A max into 2 pi. That is the value. And we know that V max is 0.08, which is given, and A max is 0.32. So we will get 1 by 4, that is 1, that is so pi by 2. And when you will put the value of pi and you will solve it, you will get 1.57 seconds. So the time period is 1.57 seconds. And the amplitude is V max upon A omega. So instead of omega, we will put 2 pi by T. And when 2 pi by T goes another side of the equal sign, we can get A is equal to T by 2 pi into V max. And we have the value of T, that is 1.57. That is pi by 2 into 0.08. So after solving this, you will get 2 centimeter. So the next numerical is example 5.7, and in this example, the question is, describe the state of oscillation if the phase angle is 1110. So 1110 means 3 into 360 plus 30. So if it is plus something indicates fourth oscillation. So during one oscillation, the particle completes 360 phase, means we will get 3, that means 3 oscillation has been completed, and the particle is in the fourth oscillation. And during the fourth oscillation, we can write sine 30, and sine 30 is 1 by 2, so A by 2. So the phase angle indicates that during its fourth oscillation, the particle is at plus A by 2 and moving to the positive extreme position. So three oscillation and it is moving towards positive extreme position, that is your positive extreme position, that is your negative, and the particle is here. So the next numerical is, while completing its third oscillation during linear SHM, a particle is at minus root 3 by 2a heading to the mean position. Determine the phase angle. So the particle is completed its two oscillation and it is heading towards third oscillation. So we can write A and A get cancelled, and we get sine theta 1 as minus root 3 by 2. So we will get theta 1 as sine inverse of minus root 3 by 2, and that is nothing but pi plus pi by 3 radian, or 2 pi minus pi by 3 radian. So for negative side, the particle is heading to the mean position. The phase angle in the fourth quadrant for that is 2 pi minus. So as it is third oscillation, phase angle, it has completed second oscillation, plus 2 pi minus pi by 3. And when you will solve it, you will get 17 pi by 3 radian. So next is, the total energy of a particle of mass 200 gram performing SHM is minus 10 raised to minus 2 joule. Find its maximum velocity and period if the amplitude is 7 centimeter. So we know that energy of a particle is half m omega square a, and this term is your maximum velocity square. So we will get V max square as 2 E by M, and V max can be written as root 2 E by M. So the energy is 2 into 10 raised to minus 2. The energy is 10 raised to minus 2, and the mass is 0.2 kg. When you will solve it, you will get my 0.13162 meter per second. This is the value of maximum velocity, and we know that maximum velocity is omega a, and omega is 2 pi by t a. So t can be written as 2 pi by v max, 2 pi a by v max. So after solving this, you will get 1.39. So the period of oscillation of a simple pendulum increases by 10% when its length is increases by 21 cm. Find its initial length and initial time period. Now consider L1 is the initial length of the simple pendulum, and when this length is increases by, so the final length will be L1 plus 21 centimeter, or we can write L1 plus 0.21 meter. And the time period is, suppose T1 is the initial time period, so the final period is increases by 10% of T1. So T1 plus 10% of T1, that is T1 plus 0.1 T1. So we will get T1 1 plus 0.1, that is 1.1 T1, that is T2. So T1 upon T2 is equal to root L1 upon L2. If T2 is 1.1 T1, then we can write L1 plus L1 plus 0.21. So this T1, T1 get cancelled. Square on both sides. So after squaring, we will get 1.21 as L1 upon L1 plus 0.21. Cross multiply it. 1.21. So when L1 goes another side of the equal sign, we will get L1 1.21 minus L1 is equal to 0.21. That is 0.21 L1 is equal to 0.21 L1 is 1 meter. So we will get L1 as 1 meter. And when you will put this in this equation, L1 T1, so you will get T1 as 2.006 second. Now next numerical is example 5.12, and it is a bar magnet of mass 120 gram. It is in the form of rectangular parallelepiped as the dimension L 40 millimeter, breadth 10 millimeter and height 680 millimeter with the dimension H vertical. The magnet performs angular oscillation in the plane of a magnetic field with period pi second. If its magnetic moment is 3.4 ampere meter square, determine the influencing magnetic field. Means we are supposed to find out B. We know that time period of a bar magnet oscillating in external magnetic field and T time period is pi. I moment of inertia. So this pi and this pi will get cancelled. Squaring on both sides, we will get 1 is equal to 4 into I mu b, or b can be written as 4 I upon mu. Bar magnet, the formula for moment of inertia is ml plus l square plus b square upon 12. So by putting this value and solving for b, we will get 2 into 10 raised to minus 5 Weber per meter square or Tesla. So two magnets with the same dimension and mass but of magnetic moment mu 1 and mu 2 are jointly suspended in the Earth's magnetic field so as to perform angular oscillation in a horizontal plane. When their like poles are joined together, the period of their angular SHM is 5 seconds. Find the period of angular SHM when their unlike poles are joined together. So we know that time period of a bar magnet vibrating or oscillating in a magnetic field is T is equal to 2 pi root I by mu b. With like poles together, the effective magnetic moment is mu 1 plus mu 2. With unlike poles together, the effective magnetic N1 minus N2. So this is T1 and T2. Dividing these two equations, we will get root mu 1 minus mu 2 upon mu 1 plus mu 2. So when mu 1 minus v 2, we will get 50, and mu 1 plus mu 2, 150, that is 1 by 3, and the T1 is 5 seconds. So T2 can be written as root 75, that is 8.665 seconds. So this is it, student. This is the numericals.